because we're not all like losing our minds trying to win a folk style state title. So the vibe is a little bit more laid back, but we're still getting the work in. All right. So I don't mind us not being in here trying to kill each other every day and being all blazer focused for a couple weeks while we're getting in the freestyle mode. But we still need to get that detail and that focus in, Kamari Reese. So one thing that we're missing is the knee under. So getting quad pod. So when I'm running gut, knee under, see how his hips, if I continue this direction, see how his hips are in my lap, okay? So when I arch, okay, it pops his hips and takes him across his shoulders. Quad pod's no different than flat on the mat. No different than him being in his base right here. If somebody bases up on you like this, send them a Christmas card after you tech fall them, all right? But they're either gonna be flat or they're gonna be in that quad pod. The only difference when we're in this flat position is I gotta have much tighter shoulder and ear drive because it's gonna be way tougher to collapse their defense. Now, we haven't talked about this guy's defense yet, but this guy's gonna be bringing his knee up and looking into the pressure. So defense for gut wrench is look at the gut wrench. Get as curled and as tight as defense as we can, because I'm gonna be driving this direction, he's gonna be circling into it, trying to keep me from turning him, okay? So it's not gonna be just as easy as crunching down on the guy and running my feet. It's tough to gut wrench a good guy, all right? At the highest level, most guys leg lace on top as opposed to gut wrench. There's some really, really good gut wrench guys out there, but not near as common turning guys with guts as it is at lace at the highest level, just because defense is tough. And it's tough to gut wrench guys when we're starting to get slippery. Biggest thing I want to see is knee digging. Okay, I got to get this wedge here. Got to get this wedge here and load these hips up so I can drive. So we're getting our lock. We're getting our drive and we're scooping. See, I'm kind of pulling them up into the wedge. Now I don't just get here and fall to my hip and pull them across with my arms. Okay, I continue to drive up that line and collapse. I drive up that line and collapse. So I just want this guy laying straight on bottom. I don't even want a ton of defense right now. I'm gonna straddle the side that I'm going to. I'm gonna knee dig and lift a little bit. Okay, and as I lift and get him up on the wedge, I'm gonna continue to drive until I got him loaded up in my hips. My feet are continuing to reload to my butt. Then when I get to this position, big pop, big arch. Recover. Every time, recover. Because I can turn around and go right back to the other side. Okay? But if we're not recovering and our lock's not tight, we're going to be one-hitter quitter type deal. Okay? We're going to get one gut wrench, then we're going to lock it down, stand back up. It's not bad. Okay? We get a takedown gut wrench, that's 4 points. It's not bad. But we won't be able to get on top and put people away. So big knee dig. If you get to that point, just like that. If I get here, okay, stop. Oh, got rich. Reset. Get your lock back center. Get that knee dig. If you get here and your head's slipping, okay, everything tight, stuck where it was when you begin, okay? They should start to feel it after about 15, 20 reps. They should start to feel it right here. It's gonna be a little crunchy. Questions? Let's go.